So previous class we learned all the sales promotion techniques. Let's just revise quickly what are the sales promotion techniques, starting from rebate, where they will be giving more quantity or less price. Either one of it will be given. So every customer will get more quantity, or they will get more quantity for very lesser price. Then we went on to see the discounts. Discounts is the mostly used in the clearance sale. So they'll have flat 50% off, flat 60% off and all that. Apart from that, the other type of discount is up to when it is given, there will be varied discounts given to different type of products. Then the next point is refunds. Whenever you get cash back on the purchase, or whenever you do a transaction and get cash back, those are refunds. Then premiums or gifts. If you shop for certain money, you will get gifts, or they will give you free mug. Then sports rackets, or this badminton racket free, toothbrush free with the toothpaste. All this are premiums. Next, quantity deals. Buy two, get three free. Buy one, get one free. All the quantity increases is called as quantity deals. Next is samples. Many times samples are usually given in the newspapers, like along with the newspaper ad, a sample will be stuck onto the newspaper. So people can use with the samples. If they like it, they can buy the products in a full range. So that is samples. Then contest. Companies will sponsor many of the events and organize many of the contest. Here for small kids, for example, Camlin, Faber-Castell, all this usually will do the painting competition. And the next one is instant draws and assigned gifts. So you will get a scratch card. If you scratch that card, whatever gift is present in that scratch card, you will get that. So that is instant draws and gifts. Then lucky draw. It is something like a lottery system where you will be given a number and you will have to actually use that number. And later, after some time, they will take out one lucky number, and whichever that lucky number is, will get a gift. Then usable benefits, like sending you on a holiday package, or giving you a kitchen set, or a complete new house. All this will be usable benefits. Then full finance at 0% is where the loan will be given at 0% interest. Maybe the installments will be increased, or the total amount of the product might be increased. And the last two points are packaged premium. Here you can have lot of products inside the actual product, or the gifts inside the actual product. That is like gold coin inside Lux soap, or you can find some gifts inside the tea powder. Okay, all this will be packaged premium. And then there is container premium. Like they give you, you buy Horlicks and they give you a plastic bottle free, or they'll give you a water bottle free. Okay. So all these are container premium. So what usually people do is they use the product inside, and again, they reuse the plastic bottles for other products. So those were the very, very important techniques of sales promotion. Now going on further, we have merits of sales promotion. Now, what are the advantages of sales promotion? Now by doing sales promotion, what all is the important points we will be knowing? So first one is attention value. So once we give out any offer, maximum of the customers will concentrate on the product which has offers. And they will try to compare which offer is better and buy the product. So we're gaining lot and lot attention from the people or customers. Then useful in new product launch. Now when we introduce a new product into the market, this sales promotion is better, because whenever we call them to buy the product, after calling them to buy the product, if we give them more offers, or if we give them some sample to use, if we encourage them to buy the product, then it is easy for us to sell more products. Then synergy in total promotion effect. Synergy is a concept where if two intelligent people, or if two people who work very hard come together, it is not only efforts of two people, but they will multiply the effect instead of adding. So synergy is always told like this. It is like it's 1 + 1 is not 2, but it is 3. Okay, so that is the synergy effect. Now, in synergy effect, they are saying that it is not only addition of two people's efforts, it is much more than that, because each one of them will be having their goodwill, they will have many other things, their knowledge, everything. So all that is very, very important here while we are promoting. So brand value of the product is also important, because we always like to buy brands which we know, rather than the very new one which we have not heard of also. So synergy is an important advantage. Then aid to other promotional tools. Now sales promotion will also encourage many other promotional tools to be creative promotional tools to be added. So salesmen will try to communicate in such a beautiful way that people are convinced to buy the product. Now when salesman does so much of job, he puts in so much of energy into it, he will be able to actually get more incentives or more commission by selling the product. So these are the major four advantages of sales promotion. Next, going on further, the disadvantages of sales promotion: reflects crisis. Now if the firm is offering sales promotion techniques again and again, sometimes what will happen if they're giving too much of discount, or too much of advertisements, it means that there is no demand for the product. Now for example, if you see this lion dates, lion honey, all this, every time 24/7 365 days, they will have an offer of 1 + 1. Okay, so such products, or there are many products like Santoor soap, Nirma soap. Okay, all these products, if demand is there or not there, all the time they will give you more and more quantity discounts, or price discounts. Quantity will be always extra. It will come in a package of 3 to 5 soaps only. Okay, nowhere you can buy them at one soap. It is very rare you find like that. So if you do too much of sales promotion, it means there is no demand for the product. So, and company is in the crisis situation. That is what people will think about. Then spoil product image. So if we give them too much discounts also, people will think it is low quality. Now even for us, when we want to buy a dress, say for example, if you want to buy a dress, then if we see 200 rupees, or let's say we see 120 rupees top. Now instead of 120 rupees top, the next to 120 rupees top, you will see another 300 rupees top. Okay, now you will compare both of it. Okay, you will still feel that 300 rupees top, quality is better, and it is okay to pay 300. This 120 rupees, even the quality is same as 300, you will still, by seeing the rate, feel no, that must be low quality. If not, why will they keep it at less price? Okay, so these are the questions which will come up in the customer's mind all the time. So too much of sales promotion also can spoil the product image. So these are the merits as well as demerits of sales promotion. Any doubts in these slides until here? So let us go to the last promotional tool, that is publicity. Now publicity is the fourth promotional tool which we will be learning. Now, publicity or public relations, both are one and the same. So what is publicity? Let us understand. Publicity is a non-personal, non-paid stimulation of demand of product or services or business unit by significant news about the service in the print media or obtaining a favorable presentation of it upon radio, television, or stage. So it is a non-personal, non-paid stimulation of demand. Now, they do something in a form of skit, or they do something in a form of, let's say, giving advertisements on radio, voice communication happens, you do a social skit or social experimentation, and we put it out on the print media, that is newspapers, magazines, pamphlets. We do some of this kind to publicize or to create awareness about the product in the customer. So that is known as publicity. Now, publicity does not use only one means of media to spread the news. We use lot and lot of variety of media, or say print media or television media or any other media like stage, theater, all that will be utilized. Then promotion or business relies on public relations. Public relations or publicity, because this business has to, if business has to make profit, the sales has to happen. For sales to be happen, we have to promote the product. So everything is interrelated. Then effect of news story carried usually free by the mass media. Now in TV9 or in Suvarna, BTV, Republic TV, CNN, we have so many news channels today, and every news channel will come up with some or the other content and have a 30 minutes or half an hour program which they highlight on lot of products, right? So apart from that, in the weekends also, they do lot of programs where they actually promote lot of businesses. Now, if we give out a Now, if we give out those our information, that is the business information, onto the media to publicize, then that is also a form of promotional tool. So, but creation of this image, it can be editorial, that is media can play a role, or it can be a independent source also. You yourself can make a movie about the company and put it up on lot of media. Then, while the publicist can control the content of the story, he or she may not have any control over the placement or interpretation by a media public relations, including ongoing activities. Now, certain advertisements are not perceived or are not taken by the customers how it is shown. Now, suppose if it is a 5-star advertisement. Now, for many of them, the way they show the 5-star advertisement, they feel like, oh, wow, yummy chocolate, it looks so nice. But there are many people who will think, see, it looks so shabby, I don't feel like eating the chocolate. So the publicist or the company can only create the content and put it on the media, but how the customer will interpret that particular advertisement depends on the person only. We cannot actually control that interpretation of the public. So that is why when advertisements are put up on the television, we have to make sure that our message reaches to the customer in a right way. If it does not reach in the right way, nobody will be taking it in that sense, and it will be very, very manipulative kind of a thing, which will change the overall public image of the company only. Then public relation activities includes helping the public to understand the company, and often public relations are conducted through media, newspaper, television, magazines, etc. So it is one of the primary activities. Why primary activities? Because if you don't publicize about the company, or let's say college, or about the product, school, industry, we will not be getting any sort of feedback or any sort of required orders from the other companies. Now, let's say we have started a company. Now, our company is manufacturing masks. Okay, very, very apt for present situation. So if our company is manufacturing masks, we have to go out and publicize saying that, see, we are also manufacturing masks. Masks are available with us also. You can buy. Now, where you can buy, you can either buy from our store or you can order online. So you will give a lot of options. Now, if at all you don't publicize at all, you manufacture, you keep it in the industry. You manufacture, you keep it in the industry. Then in that case, the stock will only pile up and you will not be able to sell any product. So public relations or publicity is very, very primary tool, and it is also very important for or to sell the product. So that is the idea or the concept of publicity. Then what is the role and significance of public relations? So when they ask you advantages, role, significance, everything means same. So here we are going to understand that. So it will help us to convey the policies and programs of the organization. Suppose if we make a small movie kind of a thing, let's say we are going to do a video about our college only. Now about our college, we are going to start with the college building in the background, give a full name of the college, elaborated name of the college. Then we will talk about what is the mission of the college, vision of the college. Then who are the main persons, who is the chairman, who is the secretary, and who is the principal. Then after that, which are departments are there, then who are the teachers, how many students are there, all that we will be talking about. So here we are giving an information about our college to people outside. Okay, so that is one of the major advantage of a public relations. Now apart from that, whenever you want to attend an interview, suppose let's say campus drive, okay, when the companies come to the college. Now when they come to the college, the first thing what companies do is they put up all the students into one hall and or the auditorium, and they will show you one small movie about their company. Now, why about their company? Before joining the company, you should be in a situation to know and understand what is that company doing. Simply, you cannot go give the interview without the information of the company. So that is the first thing about the public relations. Then help to collect information about public opinion, about the organization, management, activities, etc. Now, whatever work the company is doing, the person should be able to explain that in a good sense and collect the public opinion. Is it positive or negative, or how we are supposed to do it? So that is also one of the advantage, and that is also one of the role of the public publicity or public relations. Then to overcome the complaints and dislikes of public, if at all there is any problem regarding the product or service provided, if they did not like the attitude of any person in the company, or if they did not like any part of the company, maybe we have to rethink on arranging our showroom, or we have to add more facilities in the company. So whatever is there, negative and positive, both will be taken from the public and they will try to work on it. Okay. Now, when we get the feedback, it is not that a feedback is always negative. Okay. Feedback can be positive also. So we'll have to work towards the negative feedback and make sure we continue the positive features. So that is the point. Next point is to maintain goodwill and understanding between organization and public. Now, even if they hear some fake news about the company also, people should not be in a situation to believe about the news. So that is the level of goodwill the company should maintain. But today it is very difficult because customers are not loyal at all. So in that scenario, to maintain this goodwill, to maintain the completeness of the customer, have a good interaction, all that is very, very difficult. But still, companies are trying to have a good connection with the public. Then to build an image of the organization. Now, if the organization has built a positive image, okay, if they're able to come out with very good initiatives, if they're able to help out their employees, see, any company for that matter, people will always respect them if they all help their own employees. If they work their own employees, which means that people have the soft corner about the company. So that will also give a good image in, about the organization. So these are the role, significance and advantages of public relations. Any doubts until here? Everybody understood? Okay, so going on further, we'll have to see what are the, okay, let us see what are the other methods and tools of public relation. Now, in what all ways will they be doing the public relations? Okay, so that is also important for us to understand. How do they actually do the advertising how do they actually do the publicity? Let us understand that. Now, first is news. Many company will give, you know, a lot of news, or they want to come and highlight themselves on the news channel talking about you know, how good they're treating their employees, and yes, they're giving lot of you know, importance to the women to work in their company, so that, which means they are helping women to be more independent in the modern India. So all these are few of the you know, policies which will help company to grow better. So news is one of the ways where they will use that as a publicity channel. Then speeches. The speeches, they will be called for a guest lecture, or they will be called to just address few of the other people or students or company people. Okay, so all these are also very important in few ways. Now you can see you know, Ambani addressing the shareholders, so that is also you know, very nice to have you know, go through the video. Or you will have Ratan Tata, the Tata industry person, okay, the Tata's talking, or Infosys Narayan Murthy's talking, or Sudha Murthy ma'am talking. So all these features will influence various other people. Or you can see a lot of bank managers, okay, there will be very expert bank managers who will be talking about all this. So that is, all these speeches are, you know, will influence, easily influence people to buy the products from the particular company. So that is why companies usually have press meets happening every now and then. Okay, then events. Events refer to organizing press conference, multimedia presentation, matches, stage shows, etc. Now they, events, they always love to sponsor for events, because that will actually put up the company name more and more. Now suppose if Tata company is trying to, you know, sponsor for a college event, for example, every time they on the stage when they are talking for about any event, they will start with sponsored by Tata. So throughout the event, the Tata name is being mentioned many times, which will also make people aware that yes, Tata is doing a good job. It is encouraging lot of things. Okay, so that, other than that, that is also one of the event. Then other than that, they have press conferences. If they want to address anything to the customers or consumers or investors, they get the press conferences where the media will be present, and that will be you know, circulated through television, radio, as well as print media. Next, written materials. Written materials are balance sheet, annual reports, brochures about the company, or you will have one annual book which will be done by the company. Like how every college will have a magazine, or they'll have the newsletters. Similarly, there will be other written materials from the company. So once they send this balance sheet or annual report or any other documents, then people will be very, very impressed to know more about the company. So nobody will throw out the annual reports, because annual reports are very, very important to analyze the company financially, how the company is strong, or should we really invest into the company, or should we really buy the products, are the products genuine or not. Everything can be checked by the written material information. Then public service activities. Now, are they doing a charity program? Now it is COVID-19 situation. Now, how are they treating their employees? Are they cutting salaries? Are they giving them some or the other facilities? So in this public service activities, when they give out more and more charity shows, or if they are taking care of a school, funding a college, or they are running their own training school for employees, they make sure their employees are very, very skilled. So even if they leave Tata company or if they leave Reliance, they'll be able to get job anywhere. All these are welfare programs. Okay, they want to help their own employees and the society people to grow better, because they would have taken money from the society people only in the form of selling the product and taking the money. So in return, they also have to make sure all this takes place in a proper way. So once they do a lot of welfare programs for women and kids, and if they try to donate some not money, okay, not everybody will accept money. So if they're trying to donate some sports equipment to the schools, or they want to maintain a general park, a private park, they want to maintain well, they want to maintain roads well, all that is welcome by the companies. Okay, so that is also one of the way here. So these are a few of the methods and tools of public relation. So did you all understand the methods and tools? Any doubt in this slide? So next will be the benefits of publicity. Now, in benefits of publicity, why do we use publicity? Where all it will be used? How it is useful for different people? That also we will see. Now, first, how does the publicity benefit the manufacturer? Now, I told we are starting a company where we are manufacturing masks. Now, we are manufacturers of masks. Now, let us see how this publicity will benefit us. Increase in demand of product caused by advertising and introducing of new techniques. Sorry. Now, increase in demand of product. Now, once you publicize, or once you say people that, okay, see, our company is also giving out masks, then we are, that will create more demand for the product. Okay, so, and we can also say that, see, the mask is not hand touched, okay, it has some extra features that will help people breathe easily rather than feeling suffocated and all that. If you give new techniques and if you introduce new techniques and explain about it, then again we are benefited by the publicity, so that our demand will increase. Then advertising maximizes the production level in the enterprise. Now, any sort of advertising or promotional tool will help us to increase our production levels. So once we have more demand for our product, we have to also increase the supply. Now, to supply the products, we have to produce the product, so the production level will increase. Then reduce the slump in profit margin of the products. Now, always you cannot keep aside everything for the expenses. So expenses has to be paid off immediately, and our profit margins will also increase. So we will be in the good growth rate rather than always immediately falling down. Okay, so that is also one of the benefit to the manufacturer. Then large amount of production may lead to stabilization of value of the product. Now, if we produce more and more product in bulk, that will help me to reduce or that will help me to buy the raw materials in very good quantity, so that I may get more discount also. So large amounts of production will help me to stabilize the value of product. If I am selling, let's say for example, if I am manufacturing 10 units of the product, and if I am selling 2 units per day, then my cost is very high. But suppose if I am manufacturing 100 units, and if I am selling, let's say 90 units or all 100 units, then I will be able to manufacture more and more on daily basis, and I can give more and more of product, or I can sell more and more of product, which will reduce my cost on an overall basis. Okay, so these are certain basic benefits for manufacturer. Then seeing the benefits for retailer. Now retailer, what he actually does, he will take the products from manufacturer and he will sell it to the end customer. Now what is the benefit for retailer here? He has to get the product, keep the product in his store for good amount of time. Then he has to keep the eye on which product is expired, which product he can sell, everything he has to take care of. So for a retailer, if you publicize or if you do a publicity or promotion about your product, and when the demand increases, everybody will rush to the retail store to buy the product. So when all my products are sold, there is no risk of keeping the dead stock. Dead stock is whichever is expired. Now this dead stock cannot be sold, nor will be taken back by the company. So that is loss. So that is why maximum of the time people would love to first sell off whatever products they have and then only get the fresh stock. Okay, so that is one of the benefit. Then since advertising helps in finding a way to stabilize the price, retailer is confident of selling the product with more profit. Okay, here advertising will help us to stabilize the price. Why? Because again the demand is increasing, again the profit is increasing, people are buying the product, so it will help us to stabilize the price. So, and retailer also will think, okay, now upon this I will keep another 2 rupees and sell, so I will also get a more profit. So that is another benefit to the retailer. And then it also reduces the percentage overhead of the retailer. Now when you get very less products and sell less products, overhead is the maintenance cost of the product itself is too big. Okay, so when you get more products and sell off very quickly, the overhead of the retailer will also reduce. So these are few of the benefits to the manufacturer and few benefits to the retailer. And did you all understand the slide before I go to the next one? Any doubts? Okay, now let us learn what is the benefits of publicity to the consumer. Now we saw manufacturer, we saw retailer, and then we have a consumer. Now in consumer, what happens is if your advertisements are good, okay, if your advertisements are able to touch people really well, then people will come and buy the products. Now if you see this Dairy Milk Silk advertisement or Oreo biscuit advertisement, okay, all these you find it very cute. Okay, no matter how the advertisement is, you find it very cute. And many times kids are attracted to colorful advertisements. So if you see any product of kids, you will have animation added up. You will have people, you'll have the cartoons coming and going. Okay, so all these are involved. So when you advertise it very well like this, then in that case, you will be selling more products and customer is also satisfied. But at the same time, if you see adult products, adult people always would like to get more information, okay, about the product. So they will show some graphs, they'll show the nutrition chart, they'll show the ingredients chart, okay, that will convince the adult people to buy the product. So that is one of the benefit to the consumer. Next, it helps in educating the customer and also acts as an information service. Now, this publicity or advertisement or news form, print media, that is newspaper, anything and everything will help you to give more information about the product and its users. Now, when you are creating awareness and educating the customer about your product, they will be able to, or they'll be very happy to buy your product more and more. So, and once they buy, use it, the next time also they will try to buy the same product only rather than going to some other brand. So, you always, customers or consumers love to get educated about the product before using. Then, advertising also makes it possible to sell directly to the consumer by mail order business. This is your e-commerce. Okay, so e-commerce has a lot of options in today's world. Okay, when e-commerce is trying to, get things done for the people, then advertising also plays a major role. So that is why you can even see the advertisements of Flipkart, Amazon, Snapdeal, many other websites like that. They would love to advertise. So people, they're saying that please use such e-commerce websites where we will be able to deliver you the product on time and we have more variety of the product. So that is also few benefit to the customer or consumer. Okay, so this completes the promotional tool. Okay, all the promotional tools and four major marketing mix tool. Okay, so this is one part complete. Almost we have finished 80 to 90% of the chapter. Now last one major concept that we are left is a little part of HR in the retailing. Okay, so any doubts until here? Okay, so the next concept to start is the human resource management in retailing. Now, human resource or HR is a very, very important part of retailing. Why it is very important, let us understand. Firstly, whenever they are selling any product, we want a person who will be able to explain us about the product or who will be at least present to help us in getting the right product. Many times we will not be aware about what product to buy. So in such scenario, the HR or the employee there, okay, that person is supposed to help us. So when employees are present in the organization, the human resource department is compulsory to be there to look after the employees. So human resource management is also a very major part of the retailing activity. Now if you take for example DMart, now inside DMart you will have so many people working. You will have people filling up the groceries, you will have many at the billing centers, you will have few securities guys at entrance and exit, and there will be a separate stock or the go down in the DMart separately kept where that employees will be different to get the products inside the DMart. So now when you have so many employees, there will be a back end process of HR also happening. That HR person will take care of hiring the employees, how are they performing, and what benefits they should give, who should get more increments, how to motivate these people to work better, how do we train them, what is the uniform to be given. There are so many things that they have to consider and they have to give the complete idea about the employees. Okay, so that is a rough idea about human resource management in retailing. Okay, so we'll stop here for today and we'll continue tomorrow. We have a lot of concepts to learn under human resource management.